Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I hope you are well. Brothers and sisters, today we'll enlighten you about the scholar who died homeless and alone. Abdullah Yusuf Ali. Yusuf Ali is best known to English-speaking Muslim as the man who produced a translation and commentary of the noble Qur'an. He was born in Surat, Gujarat, India. On 4th April 1872, he was highly educated with the ICS and LL.B, LL.M degrees and was also known as Islamic scholar. He studied in Bombay at Anjuman Islam School, shifted to Scottish Institution for Better Education, attended Wilson College and completed his BA in 1891 from University of Bombay. Later on, he was provided a scholarship and £200 for 3 years for further studies in England. Being a man of great intellect and wide interest, his personal and public lives do not leave a very favorable impression. Yusuf Ali played many roles in the British as well as Indian society. His work and affiliations conceal his place in the hierarchy of the society. He was one of the most senior Muslim civil servants during the British rule, rubbed shoulders with the likes of Muhammad Ali Jinnah and Aga Khan. He had half a dozen books to his names, just as many pamphlets, over a dozen learned articles and 2 entries in the Encyclopedia of Islam. He was also a prolific writer on Islam, had worked in Islamic College. His educational tours to the Northeast represented India at the Paris Peace Talk in 1919. Was a trustee of London's oldest mosque. He had inaugurated the first mosque in Canada. MashaAllah. He was a leading spokesman on the Indian education. Ali was a devout Muslim, making sure he offered daily prayers, attended religious congregations and led prayers at the Shah Jahan Mosque. He strictly forbade political Islam and believed that Muslims could prosper under British rule as long as they focus on educating themselves. But behind the veneer of his intellect, busy schedule and scholarly importance, he was suffering from internal conflicts. His marital problems with his 2 wives or the negligence of his children are some reasons of his loneliness. Ali specifically mentioned his second son, Asghar Bulai Yusuf Ali, who has gone so far to abuse, insult, vilify and persecute him from time to time. But we might never know what broke him in the end. Later on, British had no further use of him, and so he slowly receded from newspapers. His powerful friends also abandoned him. Yusuf Ali spent his last years living in the National Liberal Club on a monthly pension that he received against his government job, as he had transferred his estates to a fund set up in his name by Court of University of London for the benefits of Indian students at the university. He was wandering about the streets of London and living in poverty despite having €20,578.16 in the bank. The face of public charm appeared to be an attempt to hide the deeper failure at personal level. He died in London on December 10, 1953, was a pathetic wreck, disoriented and confused. He was found by the police laying outside the steps of a house, taken to hospital. Subhanallah. He died unsung and unmourned, was buried in Brookwood Cemetery in Surrey. It is sad to say that a man of that caliber and intellect had met such a tragic end. It is quite unpalatable about the life of man who is known to the Muslims only as a translator of the Quran. Brothers and sisters, failures and success are 2 sides of the same coin. Don't get disappointed by failures as long as your hearts are true and your minds are not invaded by roots of evil. There is no cause for despair. A failure in one field may turn out a success in another. So keep your faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have patience, inshallah, all will be well in the end. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless Yusuf Ali and grant him the highest rank in Jannat al-Firdaus. Ameen. Brothers and sisters, if you like this video, give this video a thumbs up and share this video to your friends and family. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum.